Alright, what up YouTube? Back with another vid. Just got this in tonight. Team Corrali. I might be the first on YouTube with it. They all got the Chronos on there. But it's the first one I seen that I'm gonna see with the Dominator. Demonator, whatever the hell it's called. But I brought my Outcast out to show example. Or a comparison kind of video, trying to compare them both to each other, because you know they're obviously really similar. I don't have the stock body for mine, so it's kind of not able to do that to show the body, even though the Notorious body is almost very identical to it. But let's get into it. Sure, if you looked at the videos, you seen the controller already. The other ones were gray, this one's black. Feels cheap, ugly as hell. But I'm sure anything's better than the STX2 that they got. Here we go. Ooh, these tires feel weird. Really weird. Super soft tires. Kind of feel like plasticky. These feel like a real tire. These kind of feel plasticky. In no way, shape, or form am I an Arrma fanboy, so don't get that feeling. I'm gonna give it God's honest truth. If it's ugly, it's ugly. If it's tight, it's tight. But, getting into the body. I'm gonna go from first look, first glance. It's really nice. I'm gonna have to say that. It's really nice. I like the design of it, but I also like the design of the Notorious and Outcast body, which is kind of the same. This right here is definitely a weak point. Feels real flimsy. Definitely need Gorilla tape and shoe glue and drywall mesh on it. The body in the back, the cage is a little different. I like that. Real sturdy. Live to ride and ride to live. Corrali Garage. That design is cool though. I really like that. And then they got the indents right here. Goes all the way through. Got them up here too. That's a real nice touch. And then they got them right here too. It's a nice body. I like the look of it. All right. Watching videos, the Chronos, this has been breaking. Constantly on all the videos I've seen, probably every time they had it out, it broke. But on the Chronos, I didn't see this. This is metal. This is metal. Wow. All it. Oh my God. You guys see that? Damn. All the way down here is metal. All the way up here, full bracket metal. Solid too. Chronos does not have that. Nice fat Willy bars. Show you the Willy bar on the Outcast. If you guys haven't already seen it, but I broke it. Screws ripped out. That was the weak link since I put the aluminum on there, but that's all we have for this. But this has rubber wheels. These are plastic, but I'm sure you can swap them out to rubber. Something, it might not matter though. I can't believe they got this metal. That is a smart design. Very smart design. I think they should have did that with the Kronos too. So giving a comparison, because you guys can't lie, they do look almost identical in pictures. The tires are bigger on here on the Dementor. Definitely bigger. Probably can't see in the camera. The A-arms have been breaking too on the Kronos. But feeling them, they got good flex to them. So that's definitely a positive on there. Definitely a positive compared to the RPM arms. They're about the same. About the same. And you can see the receiver box compared to the receiver box here. They put it on the driver side or the passenger side, like in a real vehicle, if we're talking that way. It's on the right side on the motor side compared to this one is on the battery inside. So that's different. Same flat pad as the Outcast. I don't put mine on, I take mine off instantly. 2050 kV motor. Feels like a full metal ES or servo. Has the shocks fully aluminum. Look at how far down you can go on it. It's pretty far. It's nice. Plastic shock cut boots on the bottom, or whatever you want to call it. Let's see what size these shock shafts are. Let's make sure we get it zeroed out. Got it zeroed out. .32, so that's probably going to be a 3.5 millimeter shock shafts compared to the Outcast. We're going on a V4. This is only the version 1, so they started off with a 3.5 when it took them forever to get to a 4.0 on the V4. They finally came out with it. Actually, they did it on the V3 actually. That's a positive on here. The shock standoffs stick out real far from my point of view. Sticks out pretty far. When I was seeing this in the camera, looking at the Kronos, I think this is super bland. But it's also CNC'd aluminum. So that's a definite positive compared to this. Stock is a 5 millimeter stamped aluminum compared to machined aluminum, and this is a 4, if I'm not mistaken, millimeter aluminum. Yep, 4 millimeter. 4 millimeter aluminum, machined aluminum shock towers, which is definitely good. From the looks of it, the Chrono sits lower. The Outcast sits higher. Bigger tires on the Dementor. I'm sorry, the Dementor. This one sits. These have smaller tires, bigger tires, but they seem plasticky. Sorry, but I might run them and they might be different. But this sits lower. Hopefully, you can get a little bit faster. But I've been seeing, they're saying that this thing is a an animal. I mean, these motors are super, super monstrous to the point that they can't even barely run them on 6S because it's uncontrollable power, which is amazing. And then they say that their certified hobby wing ESCs compared to the stock one on here is hobby wing, but Arrma put their software on it, which kind of ruined them. Comes XT90, which is great. Everybody loves XT90, my favorite. The battery tray, nice healthy battery tray, not as big as the Outcast battery tray, guaranteed. Like it's a lot smaller than the Outcast, but the ESC is also on this side and the receiver box is also on this side, so it should have had a little bit more room in the back to go back and make it a little bit bigger, but it's no big deal. You could probably switch it out or something, maybe something like that, but no big deal on there. Comes pre-shim. They got the shims in there just like the Outcast did or the Armas do. These are real thick shims too. Nice shims. Not like flimsy like these ones, like the Armas. Oh, that's a new one. That's new right there. They're out drive cups. Are flanged on the outside. I don't know if you can see that, but compared to like Arrmas, they're not flanged on the outside. They're just all one size. Might be for strength in here. That's something to look into for the future after running it for a while. But after seeing videos of this running, or I never seen, there's not a video out of the Dementor running on YouTube yet. So, seeing the Kronos running and breaking the wing off, like almost every person that ran it broke the wing off instantly. So, I think it's going to be a little bit different for this one since it's, you know, full metal all around. It might break here or something like that, but at least they made this right here. I mean, to start with, you can get one of these in aluminum once they start upgrading them. Making upgrades for them. I'm sure maybe M2C Just Bash It might come out with it, or they might not like this company and stick to Arrma Pride, you know what I mean? But you got to pay the bills, man. You got to, whatever the demand is, you got to go for it. That's how I think. But I'm gonna take the diffs apart and look at the diffs compared to the Arrma diffs, and then see how big they are compared to them, and see how long they'll last, and hopefully, you know, get a little aspect in there if they're straight cut or straight cut or curved spline or whatever they want to call it. They got the straight cut and then they got the curved ones on the like they have on the Creighton 8S. So let's check it out. I'm gonna take it apart. I'll be right back. Fuck did I own? All right, guys. I wanted to show you something right here. This is an easy diffs to take off. It's surprisingly easier than the Outcast, and you know those are easy diffs. But look at this right here. This is the coolest thing. This is a race company. If you guys did not know, this is a race company. They're based off of two-wheel drive. Excuse me. Two-wheel drive championship, like short course trucks and stuff like that. This is where the company came from. So they're race oriented. But look at this right here. So that's mainly for like quick removing the sway bar link, for putting a bigger one in if you're changing out tunings, you know what I mean, going like that. Or it's quick for taking it out and oh my god, it's Orford's for taking it out, flipping it up to get to the quick get to the diffs. So that's a cool option right there. But it only took me 2, 4, 6 screws, but the two was for this, for the sway bar. So it'll be the same 2, 4, 6. But it just seemed like it came out way easier. It took me maybe 3 minutes. Off tops, looking at these. Looking at this diff, it is by far better than the Arrma diffs. Sorry about that. Diffs in here are by far better than Arrma's diffs. These are more of the techno soft style diffs. This is what the techno diffs look like. They got a ton of meat back here. Nice chunky teeth for the ring gear. And you see what I'm talking about with the flange on the outside. I don't know if that's a good thing, bad thing. I don't know. I've never really seen that before. They come pre-shimmed. I'm going to put it back in. I'm going to check the shimming on it, actually. But that's definitely, it's a good diff. I'll give that to them. But you see the Arrma's. Arrma's flange, or outjive cups, they're not like that. It's kind of swelled out. I don't know. That's kind of different to me. That's definitely different. That's new. I don't know what that brings to the table, but it's just cool looking at it. Something different out here. And then you got the, let me get a light on it. You got the input gear right there. Way bigger, way thicker than the Arrma's. But you know, I'm not comparing the two, saying which one's better. Everybody knows I love Arrma. You know, K8S right there. Upgraded. You seen everything I've done to it. Watch my videos. Just saying, you know what I mean? I'm just brutally honest. If one company's better than the next, it don't matter. I still love Arrma. I still love all of them. But just wanted to show you and give you my honest opinion. That's all I bought the car for. It was just to get my opinion on it and see why this company came out mocking another brand that's almost identical. Even the names, except for this one. Kronos. It's almost spelled the same as a Creighton. You know what I mean? Shogun, Talon. Or Python, I'm sorry. Python and Typhon. Come on. Bodies are almost identical. I mean, that's just kind of a mock move. Just trying to take other people's names, you know what I mean? Come up with your own things. But I'm not knocking the truck from after seeing everything about it. I'm not knocking it, saying it's a bad truck. It's just kind of weird how they named everything different. Oh, I found something else. Look at this. I don't know if you can see where my finger is, but Arrma stock does not have that. It's plastic, all plastic. And I broke those so many times out the box. Broke them after running them. I mean, you got to put a heavy load on them to break them, but they were plastic. These are cum aluminum back here. That's a plus. That's definitely a plus. Let me put this back in here and see how the mesh is. I'm not gonna put the out drives on it, or the drive shafts on it. I just want to get the mesh in there. I'll do it by myself when I'm not on camera wasting y'all's time. I got an input. Let's see. Oh my god, no slack at all. None. And I'm holding the back, see? None. These diffs might be pretty bulletproof. I'll give them that. Thumbs up to HRB, Team Corrali. But, I don't know if I have anything else to look over. It wasn't a real comparison video. I was just trying to show you, like, small opinion. But they say these do 61 out the box. Okay, the box says it does 70. But the Chronos did 61 out of the box on 6S. But let's see how it runs. We'll see how it runs when I get the next chance to run it. I just wanted to get it out there, show you guys what it really looked like up close and personal. See how I give you my thoughts on it and how I like it, or if I do or don't like it, you know. But time will tell. You got to run it and see how it handles and everything else. But appreciate you guys for watching. Hopefully you liked it. If you got any questions, you want me to look at something else and let you guys know, don't be afraid to ask, and I'll get it out there, man. Thank you guys for watching again. Till next time.